Hi guys. This time, I show the electrical parts assembly of this CNC machine and to work this machine. I also made some additional parts. This lathe is getting very close to completion. So far, there have been no major problems and the CNC lathe is coming together exactly as originally planned. It took about 4 months from the first design to the start to work of this machine. Now I can finally show everyone how the machine works. First, I would like to introduce the parts I will assemble. This is a servo motor for a spindle. It is the largest motor I have ever used. It is also the first time for me to use a servo motor. The reason why I use a servo motor is for threading. These are closed loop stepper motors for the X and Z axes. Simply put, ordinary stepper motors can control the speed and angle at which they rotate, but once they stop rotating due to overload, they lose sight of the correct angle. This is a fatal problem for CNC machines, because if the motor does not rotate at the correct angle, correct machining cannot be done. However, this stepper motor will return to the correct angle even if it stops rotating temporarily. Some may find it difficult to understand what I mean, so I will try a test. I think it is easiest to understand by looking at it. This motor is now stopped. I try to turn the shaft of this motor by force, but it immediately returns to its original position. If you do the same thing with a normal stepper motor, it will not return to the original position. This power supply has a maximum of 36 volts and 15 amps. This power supply is voltage adjustable. This is a RPM meter. It is used to know the actual RPM and as a home switch for future use of the spindle as a C-axis. To build a CNC machine, I need a CNC unit. I am using Raspberry Pi 4 installed LinuxCNC and Mesa 7C81. Please watch separate videos explaining the setup, if you are interested. Let's start. I start with the additional reinforcement parts. Wiring is done. Edit the LinuxCNC HEL file to modify the pin configuration. Each home switch and motor should work now. This is the HEL file after modification the pin configuration. Let's check if the home switch works. X, Y axis and the spindle home switches seem to function correctly. The next step is to modify the INI file by calculating the scale of the stepper motor. This is the modified INI file. Let's test to see if I have set it up correctly. Let's move it by 0.1 millimeters. It seems to be working on the correct scale. The next step is to test homing. After installing the cover, it is finally complete. Next time, I will test cut to see how well it performs. See you soon.